right. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Springtime OST Mania Free-for-All Tournament 3rd Edition Grand Finals Mappool Showcase. It has been a long time coming, but this is the last Mappool that we'll be seeing in the tournament. I am going to be one of the commentators, the Toaster, joined by Daiki. How is it going?
I'm doing really great. I'm really excited to see this Mappool, especially since the first map of the Mappool will be coining!
All right,
joke's over.
I hope that burned your eardrums. I sincerely do.
Not to clean up all these coins.
As do I.
All right, so whenever Walter Tor decides to switch over to the correct first map of the showcase.
Let me tell you, I've seen this map pool and it is a doozy.
It is quite the map pool. There we go. We got, what? Oh, I guess that's the actual time. Some lore boost. Easy gave me this MP3. Anyways, we have beautiful beachfront properties by Nero's Stay at Disneyland.
Yeah, that metadata is exactly correct. It's from some Lauren Boosfield album. I don't know. Easy gave me the MP3. If that's not the name album. It's in the name of the... I'm sorry. Anyways, some people have seen this. It was mapped for Mama Cha Cha by your boy Giller Metziet. First map by the selectors that we'll be seeing, and most certainly not the last. There are plenty of Giller Metziet and Gekido maps in this.
Wait, wow, this is a really short song. This is only 1 minute long.
Yes, it is very short, but it is also very, very, very fast. The bursts are so rude.
Ooh, I see 291 BPM. Oh, that's nasty.
I'm pretty sure these are 12 bursts, so those bursts are coming in at almost, what, 400 BPM at that point? Or, no, that's not right.
Something up there.
Either way. Yeah, and they're not, like, jump-drillable.
Oh, yeah, these are not jump-drillable. These are, like, you need to have the speedy speed.
Really do. Luckily, the ending of it's a bit easier than the opening of it, but... That's not really saying a whole lot about it.
So the 12 births are indeed 436 BPM.
They're kind of fast.
Yeah, and there's actually some 30-second births thrown in there, and that's 582 BPM. No problem.
Trying to jump trill 582 BPM burst. That's what? Trying to jump trill almost 300 BPM. Oh, nice. Not that it would work anyways, but either way, we're already done. Wow. But yeah, that is going to be map number one. We'll be moving on to map number two, and we're going to keep the memes going, or at least the one meme that we've had continue through SOFT 1 and SOFT 2, if anyone remembers. Assuming this is in the right order.
I believe so. And this is a meme that wouldn't be broken in a million years.
Never ever. We have to find different versions of the same song and just keep going with it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we're waiting on a... There we go, we got... Yet another Millennium Queen.
But this one's not made by Kamikaze, so it doesn't count.
Yeah. Still. It's by Gekido instead. Just arguably even worse.
Kinda. I expect this to be a little bit more forgiving in the jacked
department. That's a really bad background. But... I know it's like... Hey. An inverse of an image, of still.
Yeah, it's the inverse of the image used for the background of the actual true Millennium Queen. I actually have not seen this map though, so it's going to be pretty interesting to see how this goes. Oh, LN streams. I mean, those don't look too bad, but Gil doesn't seem to be having the best of time. Jax! I told you that it would be a little bit more forgiving in that department, but that doesn't mean it's going to be nice.
Yep, we got some full inverse jump stream, hand stream stuff. It's pretty light, so it's not the worst yet, but I'm imagining... There we go. Ooh!
These are, like, uber extended.
Yeah, Gekido is not... The person who actually charted this isn't even having that much fun right now.
Oh, let's... no!
Oh!
No!
Full inverse jacks!
No!
Oh, split jump jacks!
Man.
That was an interesting burst.
I'm worried about this ending. Oh, it just keeps adding mini jacks in. The inverse keeps adding mini jack patterns. I am so terrified right now. Okay, so we have back to the beginning. Oh, delay master.
All right. Looks like we're gonna hit some triangles.
This doesn't look fun. Oh, that's all I'll say. And as a player who's going to be like actually practicing this pool and playing it next weekend. Oh, no.
Oh, these patterns. Ooh.
No.
That's not. That's like almost full inverse, but not.
Oh, jacks are back.
Oh, roll. That's an easy way to drop your combo right at the very end.
Here we go. We got more memes coming in. We got two jokes in a row. Nice. Our first SV pick incoming, though. This is gonna be good. I'm excited to see people's reaction.
Oh, this song! I love this song.
This chart is hilarious, by the way. Ah, here we go.
We got some minefield surfing.
Trapman featuring Creepworks. If you've seen the BMS chart or have been keeping up with the memes lately regarding Mania, you should probably know this.
Man, I've known this song since like last year, so let's be real.
When is this chart?
Mania community, get on your A game. So slow.
All I know is that this is kind of a mimic of the BMS chart, the same, or Poppin chart? I don't know which one it is. But it does mimic the same kind of thing that one of the other games did, where every time it changes BPM, which you can hear, the scroll speed changes in the same way.
I believe we might have a client reopening. I don't know if that's already happened yet because I don't have the stream.
No, it looks like it's working.
Yeah, it looks like it's working, yeah. I just missed that. There was a client reopening just to fix chat so everyone can see what everyone's saying. But yeah, minefield surfing.
Yeah, and this was made recently, but it is pretty similar to, like I said, it's pretty similar to one of the BMS chart of
that
it.
Background. Oh my god. Why are you using ITG mines? This is such a good background. Oh my god.
So it's really good. But this doesn't look too hard. It's just a bit of slow jam. What? How could this possibly be hard?
Yeah, except if you know the song, you know the BPM of this song.
Somewhere between 1 and 250, I don't know.
Somewhere between, I believe, 1 and... Yeah. I mean...
If that means anything, you can probably already see some of those effects kicking in. And if you're, like... If you'll notice that both of those player scroll speeds are pretty low, and they've been pretty low for a while, so you might think that, I can just, you know... throw my scroll speed up and react a bit faster to when it increases speed, but you actually can't do that because of something that happens at the end where it becomes
like this.
Yeah,
except even more so.
Yeah, it gets worse. Oh, and here comes the actual, like, oh, Sojin. It gets a little more sporadic around this point where it just kind of has a speed of seemingly randomly. But this is the main portion of it that you're going to need a slower scroll speed for, because this is, while this is easier to predict and the pattern pretty much stays the same, it still gets to a point where you probably can't read it if you're on scroll speed.
And it also goes faster and faster, so like you can't, that was some nasty one-hand drills.
The quad at the end just there to mess your day up. But that was map number 3. Map number 4, and we do not have a meme for this one. It's an actual map.
Tornado!
Made by someone who's in Grand Finals! Made by Intellizer. I'm sure lots of people have seen this map as well, but it, unlike his maps from the previous two map pools, this is not an LN map.
Yep, we just got straight up fastest crash incoming, guys.
Mini Jack tech, kind of heavy, very, very stamina draining, especially if you're bad at controlling Mini Jacks and Bloods. So, this is a pretty tough pick. So, that's kind of just how this pool is going to be going in general.
Yep, at 4 minutes and 30 seconds in length, at 175, there's. Ooh, hello. That was pretty.
Too hard of patterns yet, but we also haven't gotten to the big chorus or ki section. Luckily, this map actually isn't too long in comparison to what you might expect from a Camellia song. Clocks in. Oh,
I mean,
this is pretty long, but
this section is pretty nice.
Long jacks. So I was wrong about it not being long. It's 4.5 minutes. For some reason, I remember it being like 2.5.
Yeah, no.
It's pretty long, so you gotta hold that stamina with these three-note jacks and quads.
But yeah, that was some over, like, some really, really dense jump quads right there. And here we go. Okay. Oh, God!
Shoutouts to, what's it called? What's the DM of this?
175.
What? Oh, so this is actually very similar in speed to Black Hole from last year. It's not a little bit faster. I think Black Hole was like somewhere around high 150s. So it's definitely faster, but
oh my god. What is this?
It's hard is what it is. Oh yeah, okay, so Exile from last year was 157. So there is a bit of a sizable jump, about 18 BPM between here, or sorry, 17 BPM, maybe so. It is
a- We got the space time.
Ah yes, staircase pattern, my favorite. So it increases the BPM by 18, which is a sizable amount. But patterns are also slightly easier, if you can even say easy in any situation with this map.
Back into these nice jacks.
Both players still holding 98s though, which is kind of really good.
Yeah. Ooh, left jack though.
Pattern slightly easier, I think, than the beginning ones were, but still.
Looks like it.
They're definitely less dense than the beginning was, except maybe not now.
Oh, there's polyrhythms all up in this. Ooh,
I too love both. Now they're mixing both kinds in. Come true. Oh no.
Ooh, boy.
It's getting denser and denser, adding more polyrhythms to the field. I don't expect a lot of people to have fun with this.
Looking at map pool notes, according to the selectors, this is arguably the second easiest chart in the map pool.
Excuse me?
That's what I see written.
Actually, I don't have map pool notes. I just have the list. But either way,
I got you covered there then.
Yeah. I don't know a lot of the maps in this pool, but I disagree with that wholeheartedly. But that's partially because I'm an LN and SV boy, and I'm very bad at Jags. So, oops. But that's it for Alan. Speaking of Alan, we got some more incoming. And this one I did not want to see in this pool, but oh well.
Oh well. There are some worse ones that you saw in the pool later, right?
You're absolutely right about that.
Arctic birds.
Yeah, Arctic birds. Possibly incoming. If that gives anyone a hint as to one of the maps later on.
Regardless, we have Shitsubo Choco. Except it's not really the normal rice pick that you would expect from a song like this. It's a LN pick.
It's Arquinoli Virus's signature. I'm going to take a Leaf song and make it an LN map.
Yeah.
This one is a lot based on how fast you're able to hit these patterns. So, like, the LN play by itself isn't super important, but it's still notable in that if you can't read through this dense of LNs, you're probably not going to be able to play this chart.
Yeah. I mean, even if you only read note heads, like, mastering the fact that this is, like, basically inverse is a completely different story.
Yeah, and I mean, there are different points in this where sometimes you'll have to make sure you're holding on to inverse, and there's some points where you just have to make sure you're reading them right and hitting them, because all of the LNs will be short LNs anyway, so you don't even have to hold them. By the way, this is probably the second easiest LN chart in the pool. From my personal opinion, the easiest one is the consistency one, which makes sense for it to be easier, but if you're not able to hold consistency on LN, not the easiest.
I mean, you have plenty of split jump trolls, and this is a 220, and sustaining those, especially considering like full inverse in mind, is quite challenging.
Oh yeah, and the thing about it is that since we're on Scorby 2 as well, if you mess up one of the split trills and you start either rushing or falling behind and you get one combo break on them,
that's an entire column that just gets messed.
Yeah, you're not recovering from that. The LNs are they're short enough that even if you try to let go of the column in entirety, the miss from the release will just give you another combo break on the other one, guaranteed. So it is really hard to recover from a column lock on this map.
I love overstepped things.
Absolutely. So here we go. Next map in the pool. Roll question mark. Polyphonic branch featuring Unsi and Lan. C158H251N39046.
Just beta endorphin.
Hey, so I want to say all the letters and numbers. It's okay. This is a map. Upload.
Then why not just say all the letters and numbers? Then you'd say all the letters and numbers already.
Oh, yeah. This was a map made by Squid, but it was uploaded by Guillaume Mezget for this tournament. If you've been keeping up with the reform dance that DD Mythical has been making, you might have seen a version of this on rates considered for Gamma. Luckily, this is a bit slower than he planned on putting in that, so
It's still no less dumb.
It is, yes.
Let's be honest here.
It gets really dense in the choruses. The intro and outro are pretty easy, in all honesty. But once we get into the chorus, they get kind of dense. Just to say the least. I like that hand, that hand glut pattern.
Yeah, there's just like a little spike of hand gluts just sprinkled in there.
I too love combo breaking.
Well, you're going to be the one playing this.
I am the one playing it, you're right. I get to see how I fare against Lotus on this. But yeah, here's the chorus, and as I said, it gets a little more dense. Just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
I need to check the BPM of this.
160.
160. Aw, yeah. Holding consistent glut, or like consistently doing these glut patterns for the amount of time that the chorus has to do them for is really tiring. And having to do that at 160 is kind of hard. Just, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it for pick number 6, I think. It was 6. We'll move it into pick number 7 coming up. And this is one I actually don't know.
This is another Gekido song. Are you excited?
Oh,
for Hibidarake no Me.
This time it's not an LN chart, though. I can say that much.
Alright, so I'm reading the Mappool notes. It says, this is a ... pick. It's 4 All minutes right. long, 220 BPM with speed up, so it gets faster. And the description says, if you thought Tokyo was a weird song in chart, then you're in for another treat.
Oh no, if this is like Toki, I'm terrified. Oh, yeah, because Toki was used that...
There's going to be some good stuff in here.
Toki used that ... description, too.
Some releases.
Man, this isn't hard. Why is this in Grand Finals? Come on.
Gil already breaks.
What a bad player. This is some weird LN pairing, though.
Both players already breaking in this intro. Ooh. Hello.
Slow down.
Ooh, we got some devours for all of you who played FFR and know that chart.
Oh, I haven't played that chart, but I remember nothing about it because I...
It's the one with the...
my memory.
One column jack with the rolls that come in while the jack is...
Oh, no, I remember
Anyways.
That. Ew.
Oh, inverse.
Hello, inverse.
I thought I said this wasn't an LN chart. Come on.
Well, it's looking pretty LN now. Oh, hello.
Oh, nice patterns. I can sense that this is going to be pretty anchor heavy.
I mean, we're not even like a third through the chart right now.
That's fair. So we've had 2 4-minute songs already, but we've also had 2 songs less than 2 minutes long. Got both sides of the spectrum around these parts.
Oh, this is OD 9.2. Jeez.
Oh, no.
This is going to be also really hard to hack.
Flam with LNs.
Some small staccato LNs as well.
Yeah.
Ooh, slow down.
That's me.
All right, and back to full speed.
Polyrhythms.
That left hand trill. Not too hard. But something's probably gonna happen soon. Ooh. There's gonna be a jump scare.
Just like a huge teleport at me? Oh my god! I guessed it! I did not expect to be right about that, honestly.
What the?
What just happened?
Okay. What is this song?
Who knows? Your guess is as good as mine.
Those rolls are really... Oh, it's speeding up.
This is gonna be really challenging to get accurate.
Oh boy! What the heck? Apparently it goes up until 400 BPM?
What is that ending pattern?
Oh. And a break.
What? Look at that time chart. It's almost over. Is this slowing down? It is.
Yeah, it's slowing down.
Oh, still going.
Oh, this is 0.1 scroll speed.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Well, at least the patterns aren't hard.
Yeah, I think it's just really wonky.
Just a little bit. But here we go. Got another pick on the way. This one's not by Gekido, but it was uploaded by Gekido. A map made by High19, Necrosy, Drown into Perdition. This is really, really fast.
This is...
I've never seen the chart, and I'm terrified because it's 320 BPM, I think.
Yep, it's 3 minutes 20 seconds of 320 BPM.
Oh.
But yeah, I guess it jumps every beat, so every four notes.
Okay, so that's sort of light jump stream.
Yeah, I think that's the densest it is.
I'd imagine that the patterns aren't too hard. Just
High19 is generally fine with his patterning of harder songs. Like, you won't see... Yeah, that's not the worst.
Yeah.
But it's still pretty bad, I think.
He makes it so that you can play them, but when it comes to single streams, he's the rudest person.
Single streams, it's like everything's out the window. Sorry, dude.
He has a very specific way of making single streams, and he does it anytime he makes them. It's like the same type of patterns.
But yeah, so this is really fast.
Yeah. Only 320. It's not too bad, right?
Oh.
Luckily, the entire chart isn't jump stream, though. That would be pretty tiring if it was. Just that opening section of really hard jump stream at 320 BPM, but I'd imagine there's more incoming at some point.
Here's your, taking a little break section.
Here's your hit the tab button and miss one of the easy notes section. Just because you're trying to look at the other player's score. I guess these patterns look almost split jump drillable. Almost. Obviously.
For the most part.
That, but...
Well, obviously. But they're patterned in such a way that you can kind of like intelligently flail your fingers and you'll get somewhere.
It's like the least stamina intense patterning you can make despite still being 320 BPM.
Yeah. I mean, your other alternative is to just, like, make everything very left, right, hand centric and have, like, 1, 2, and 3, 4 jumps all over the place.
And then just have the player straight jump drill it all?
Pretty much. Which is no I fun mean, for a soft grand finals, let's be honest here.
When you get to speed like 320 BPM, it becomes easier and easier just to get good judgments while still just jump drilling all the time.
There's the
textbook high 19.
Yep, as soon as it transitioned into like very light jump stream, it's like there you go, there you get the little hidden mini jacks with those mini trills.
I love trick stars. All right, so next pick coming out is going to be another LM pick. I heard you guys really, really love LMs, so we're just putting so much in this pool.
And incoming one, anime!
Anime! I love anime. Underjoy, your boy, making Infinite Synthesis, LM Universe difficult.
Why are these songs so long? 6 minutes and 47 seconds.
Because Mappool selectors hate you. There's another longer pick, I'm pretty sure, later.
Nope. This is the longest chart of the entire tournament, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. You'll never see anything longer. Thankfully.
Sorry, there is a long pick suit. There's one more long pick outside of the tiebreaker, but it's only 4.5 minutes. So, and yeah, remember how I said that that Shitsubu Choco was probably going to be the easiest outside of the long note consistency pick? Well, this is the long note consistency pick. And you have to be very, very consistent, given the length. Even if the patterns are easier in general, they are strewn with mini jacks, despite being like kind of a low BPM, they are still pretty tricky if you have weak finger independence. And given how long this is, it's going to be very hard for the players to not choke, at least somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Like yourself.
Yes.
You're gonna have to watch out for your neck if you don't want to choke there.
Hey man, I thought I was gonna choke move that body, but I choked Dodger's gadget instead.
Yeah.
So you never know what'll happen. I feel like the map selectors. I have this feeling that the map selectors were actually debating using the higher rates of this map, because the map set that it's in does offer 1.1 and 1.2 and I think 1.3 and 1.4 as well for rates. Oh, these LN patterns. These are probably more to read than anything else. It's kind of similar to Shitsubu Choco, but that was more dependent on your speed on top of being able to read through the LN patterns. But this one is more of, do you have LN skill on top of being able to read really hard patterns?
Yeah.
Plus mini jacks, because meme. Gotta be careful with some of these quads, because what you'll notice is that in front of almost every single one of these quad LMs is that there's just a note like right before it, so you have to do kind of an implied mini jack. Well, not implied, but
an actual mini jig, and a lot of times the quads will be LMs on their own. So if, I mean, I have problems controlling like mini jigs into LMs just because I get too in the groove of doing the mini jig pattern, and then I just let go right after I hit the first note, the long note. Some of these jack patterns just are not very nice. I don't know what else to say about this. We're only halfway done. When will it end?
I'm about to fall asleep.
I'm sure that's what our commentator will be doing all weekend.
I mean, it's... You know, if the second half is better than the first half, then why not just cut the first half under Joy? Like, that's an option, you know? You don't have to make a 6.5 minute.
Because cutting songs is what losers do. Just like the person who made the next map who cut the song. You'll see why that's at all funny.
Oh, ha ha ha, you're making a self-deprecation joke. Because the next map is probably going to be yours.
Yeah.
Okay, the map is getting a little bit spicier here.
Oh, yeah, a little bit. Just a little bit.
Just wake up a little bit from your nap, be like, oh, I can't hit these patterns anymore.
Wow, Snore, why is this in Grand Finals? Then this chorus comes up and you're like, wait, wasn't I able to hit these patterns before? And then you realize that they changed. You don't know what...
Nice lacrimas.
Lacrima trills really add a sense of a dynamic to each other.
Oh, come on.
Why
is that even necessary?
This is an Underjoy map we're talking about. Come on.
I mean, touche. Not even a smooth speed up. Come on.
Lazy.
This map speaks to just being a lazy mapper in general.
Oh, nice. What is this? I don't know what to feel about this part.
I have feelings about this chart.
LM dumps. The best types of charts. What are these trills? Someone's gonna choke that. Someone is going to. Just miss the first one or get bad judgment on the first one, get 12 200s in the same spot.
What? Oh my god.
That was a chart. It's almost over, I promise. That timing, that time chart is closed.
What are...
Come on, just end.
Ending badly, oh my god, it's just gonna be like...
Okay.
Fall asleep for the first half, get a bunch of misses, be like, well, I guess I'll make it up in the second half when things actually happen.
That's funny. But that is the end of the long note consistency chart. And we're going to get some more SVs coming right at you. But these aren't hard SVs. It's mostly hard because of the patterning.
We've got some dysnomia coming.
Short version. And that has no spaces because the editor was being very rude to me and wouldn't let me put spaces. But yeah, this is a chart made by myself. Oblivion difficulty. It's very technical, kind of bursty, jacky. Well, no, it's not jacky at all. It's just bursty and has things. But you'll notice that is really not the main portion of the difficulty. What you really have to worry about with this is reading it. The SVs make it very difficult to read.
I mean, let's also be real. There was also the fact that this is OD 9.8.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. It is OD 9.8.
Yeah, OD 9.8. Just no problem. Just.
Just a slow game to start, but once it this picks up pretty quickly. Yeah. I don't know what
some
else.
Nice little stutters.
They get a bit more aggressive once the actual PI kicks in, or the chorus, or whatever you want to call it.
I feel like so far it's barely intuitive.
Yeah, it's not too bad. It's mostly intuitive for the entire thing, but it just like it's hard to explain why this is so much more difficult, but with all the changes, it just kept the same in every single note. So you can read through it, but with how much they're just like skipping by, it's almost like the map is lagging.
Yeah, that's the general feel I can get from this.
So reading through something like that can be really challenging, and this is definitely not an exception to that. And someone's internet is.
Oh dude, I think Gil just lagged out.
Yeah. But this is
not
that long. Yeah. Oh, Gil, this is. Throwback to MWC 2017 finals when Gil did this during the tiebreaker. Thanks, Gil. Yeah, then it just ends with a slow jam with some pretty mean anchor patterns, but it's really not too bad overall. It looks like stream already finished because they panicked. But that is it for, I think that's the second SV chart in the pool.
Believe so.
But moving on, next choice is going to be another Giller Messier chart. Bring me the horizon.
Can you feel my heart?
I think my voice started lagging because my client died.
Regardless, the 11th song in the map pool. We got a speedy boy here. It's only 128 BPM, but
always gotta have that butt.
You can already kind of see it's not just straight 1/4 screaming. Oh, I see. We get some 1/8 patterns coming in. Ah, so this is actually 1/12 snapping. So 384 BPM streams. That's getting pretty fast up there.
And as is expected from Gildy, patterns just are not forgiving at all. Lots of implied mini jags, as well as a lack of patterns that allow you to even remotely split jump trail them. Oh, that was not a funny. Okay. Yeah, I just started seeing this man, so I'd assume one of those extended ones was already there. Jeez.
Yeah, and imagine how tired you are from basically blasting that speed throughout this whole song, and you had to do it just one more time for this last bit.
Luckily, it's not too long, so you don't have to hold it for that long of a time.
Yeah, the lengths in this pool in particular are very polarizing, where you're going to have one really, really long song, and then you have like 2 minutes, 1 minute, no problem. Regardless, we're going to get into our next LN pick.
I heard you guys really, really love Gekido's LN charts. So we put two in one pool.
Yeah, we got Carnation coming at you, the CK remix.
This is really hard. This is one of those maps that I actually know, and it's very hard. very common with Gekido's LN charts, this revolves around the need to have extremely good finger independence, as most LN charts do, but this just takes it to another level. It doesn't, however, have that many mini jacks in it, which is very weird for Gekido.
Think.
The patterning is mostly comfortable, kind of, but it's just made in a way that requires you to really focus on keeping your fingers from, like, holding on together. Like, you can't lift them both up at this.
Is this an remix? Because if it is, then good job on metadata, Gek. Lemon
CK,
God.
Carnation CK remix. Not sure. Ah, these streams look fun, right? Almost inverse. Almost.
Ew.
So I guess it is made by CK? And it just, the title has CK remix in it? I actually don't know what this is a remix of.
Ah, okay. So original song was by, so this is probably the actual CK remix? Maybe.
Who knows?
Dunno. Shrug.
Good conversation we had about metadata of this map, because it's already over. Wow.
Wow.
That was short.
Yeah, not compared to that boring long note anime song. Let's
Hey, this one has anime in the background, so it's okay. It fits. As is to be expected from Osmania.
All right, but unfortunately, we got another long song from you.
Hey, wait, I thought Evening deleted this chart.
Some good old Imperial Circus. Dead Decadence. Shinbatsu Tarubi Kyoko Sumitaru. I think I got that right. Maybe. Probably not. But whatever. I sold Stamina at 250 BPM. So yeah, there's like two breaks.
There's two breaks.
Yeah, that's it. And then the rest of it is like... Okay.
All I know is that this isn't the one with the quad jacks at the end, and I'm okay with that.
it's not quad jacks, but it's a.
It's jacks, but it's not quad jacks.
It's core jacking, at least.
Okay, that's a decent play. Okay, well, these patterns aren't too bad, I guess. They're dense, but they give you. It's like broken hamstring. No, it's not broken. I'd imagine that the three players left in the tournament could definitely hold their own on this speed. It's just kind of holding focus and stamina throughout these patterns.
Including yourself.
Yes, I have to be impartial to myself. I can't just say, I know I can.
that gives away information that other people know. It's not like it matters. Lotus and Intelizer are both absolute beasts when it comes to jump stream, so I think it's obvious that they can handle that speed. Jump stream!
Yay.
Hey, well, at least this one's more interesting than the long note map.
Yeah, definitely. Because this one actually has, like, your arms falling off after the end of
this. It does, you're right.
I think that was the first break, though.
Oh, that was a short break.
Yeah. Yeah, this ain't a break. Look at that left hand. maybe this is a little... No, it's not really a break. You're still using up a lot of stamina to hit these. Yeah, there's no way a break.
What's the BPM of this? Like, 240?
250.
So 125, Jake. It's not too bad, I'd imagine.
But when you're trying to conserve...
Yeah, that's true.
And, like, after you've already gone through, like, about 2 minutes of 250 streaming, like, hitting those accurately, especially if you don't want to, like, dunk your score, is a lot harder than it seems on paper.
Yeah, especially important to note is that these streams are strewn with, like, pretty difficult polyrhythms with 12 patterns in the middle of them. So, or 6 patterns, I guess it would be in this case. But, yeah, throwing those 6 polyrhythms in are a huge damper on your stamina, especially if you try to hold yourself to a consistent 250. It just does not help.
Yeah, this is the thing, is that it's much more than just 250, because there's like a bunch of other random crap that's like all over the place. Like, you look at this and it's like also you get like little bursts here and there, also some quadrifinix pan stream bullshit.
But this time it's at 250, so it's like quadrifinix 1.3.
Yeah.
Or 1.3. That's like 1.4 or 1.45.
Thanks for the sub, yeah.
Oh my god. Nice.
What are these patterns? It's just not letting up at all.
Worth it to laugh at the patterns, dude.
Is it a break? Yep, here's your break.
Take away the pain of having to play these patterns.
Before the last minute of... There we go.
Just a little section for you to sort of gain back here.
No, this is...
Well, now it's not, but it kind of was before.
A little bit before, but...
Nice. Let's see how the players handle this. I'm gonna be bad at this. Well, that was fun. Looks like we only have 2 more maps left until tiebreaker, though. We're almost done.
And Lemon Guy is in pain.
He is in pain. But we have our final SV choice of the ghoul.
I hope he doesn't lament his choice to be playing this map pool. Because we got this lament configuration.
Yeah, but I actually checked this map out before the showcase happened, and I really enjoy this chart. Like, I enjoy this a lot. The little gimmick it has for one of the SV patterns is really neat. But this is probably the hardest one in general to learn, just from, like, or rather, it's the most SV-esque chart. If you compare it to the SV picks from the previous pools that we have in Grand Finals. I mean, when you compare it to stuff like Minefield Surfing and Dysnomia, this is a bit more streamlined for what you'd expect.
Nothing like a good old buggy desolation.
Yeah, they didn't even use the desolation difficulty in this.
Yeah, it was sad.
And there's that gimmick. I love that gimmick so much.
Oh, that's so fun.
Because it just gives you a tiny glimpse of what you have to hit, and then, like, it lets you know what you're going to have to do. This part is weird, but, you know, we'll deal with it. I wouldn't say this is too hard to learn in general. Definitely has some little tricks you can use to make sure, you know, you actually have them down properly.
Yeah.
Yeah, but if you notice that the pattern to those teleports is that it'll have one jump and then it'll have the inverse of that jump. So if it's a 1-3 right off, right at the start, it'll be a 2-4 on the second one. So it's really pretty easy to get down right away. But it's just a matter of reacting to it when the first note actually gets there and reading that first note properly.
Yeah, this is going to take a little bit of learning, though, still.
Some of the patterns are definitely choke-worthy. Like, there's a one-handed trill in a couple of the patterns.
Great ending as well.
One-fourth patterns is slow. I love that pattern, too, because it's like a single helix of DNA, just like in the background.
Oh,
artistic, huh?
Artistic jumps, yes. Alright, but our 15th and final normal song in the map pool, we have those Arctic birds coming right at you. We got Penguin.
Hell yeah. I hope you guys really enjoy this pick, because I don't.
136, so fairly short. 170 BPM, but of course it's LN Master, so like,
I'm pretty sure everyone in the chat knows this map already. I don't even think we need to show it on stream, but it's very hard. It's very gimmicky, and it's basically the whole point of it is, can you read these types of patterns and hold your stamina long enough on the speed of the LMs without column locking? The moment you column lock in this on SCAR-V2, you are done. You're not responding.
Your life will be over.
It really will be. You might have a 97% in, but you column lock once. Oops, you're at 92 now. Sorry.
Let's go. Oh.
I don't know how they're holding so strong right now. Jeez. Oh, there's one of the column locks in Jekido. Dropped to 96 from 99. There's another one. He ain't recovering from it. And that is what I'm talking about when I say you're not going to come back if you column lock.
Is Gil FCing right now? Nope.
Nice column lock.
He column locked like all of the columns.
I wonder if this is going to be played in any of the three possible matches that are going to happen.
I think it's going to. Especially, once we hit that winner's bracket. Whoever's facing Intellizer has a mountain to climb, and I expect everyone in the loser's bracket, so that's you and Lotus, to be putting in enough practice to at least take some off of Intel.
But yeah, hopefully. Hopefully. We'll see what happens.
We will indeed see what happens. However, we have our final song of this map pool, the tiebreaker. We have Coin It! Nope, it's Furries, actually.
Furry cannon. Oh, panic. Sure will be happy.
Yeah, we got some furries coming in here. We got Furry Cannon.
This is a map by Curiosity. And you'll know this name if you paid attention to the past pools, because Curiosity also made Ragnarok. You know, that map with the really cool ending patterns. Haha, 225 BPM Ham Trills. Haha, 225 BPM Lacrima Trills.
Haha.
Haha.
But yeah, this is your final song in the entire Soft map pool of Soft 3 tiebreaker. Yeah.
You said it.
I guess there is a fuzzy in the background.
There is a fuzzy. It's a little Red Riding Hood with a big bad wolf. Is this the big black?
I mean, it's 175 BPM.
From what I've heard about this map, though, it is very in comparison to like any other tiebreaker we've seen.
All right, let's see some SVs. There we go. There we go. There we go. Now it's living up to the SV Kerfice title that has been given. Got that nice build up.
That's not too hard to read yet, but that may change.
Oop, hello.
Whoa!
Whoa. Ah. Oh!
What? I like those SVs, but whoa! Yeah.
That's some nice patterns. Nice density as well. Oh my god. Yeah, that's a basically 350 BPM light jump stream with some density spikes right there.
Oh, he's LN.
We got some little technical LN releases as well.
So far, it's still in the situation where most of the SVs have been sight reading, so.
Hope.
Whoa.
Oh god, this is. Man.
These are some really bad jazz.
But yeah, this is only a 5.86 stars. That's nice. Nice slow jams. Are you ready for this to be a true tiebreaker? We're gonna get some real good long notes coming in pretty soon, I'm pretty sure.
Long notes? I love long notes.
Yeah, especially on OD9.
Oh yeah. This reminds me of the same kind of quote-unquote inverse that you would see in...
Ooh, those 1-6 bursts.
Shoot, what's it called? Messenger 2012, which was the MWC Finals tiebreaker last year. Getting a little bit shorter. At least the LNs from the transition section, even. I'd imagine it gets a little bit harder in terms of LNs, so I guess we'll be seeing how that goes.
At least this is a little break section. What?
Those are...
I'm pretty sure it's stuttering here as well.
It is.
Which makes it just that much harder to read. Oh, these patterns. What are these?
They're not that bad. I think the real annoying part is the jacks when you transition from the LMs or from the jacks into the LMs.
Those releases are also pretty bad. Nice slow jam.
Oh, nice stutters.
Oh god, those stutters. You're gonna have to study this chart if you want to get those releases correct. Those stutters active. Ew.
Whoa.
Oh no! Okay, so I was about to mention that some of those Korjak sections, or like the blood sections, were pretty nice to you because they do the thing where anytime there was a regular jump, it'd be a 1-2 or a 3-4, but then they just kind of threw
it. Then it's like, hello, split jumps. Yeah. Got 1-3, 2-4. And we got some extended Korjakin coming in at the end. And I think it just calms down with a nice slow jam. Mappool notes also say, please don't sight read this.
I think that's in reference to the Lothus versus Intel match where both of them sight read the tiebreaker. But that's it.
Yep. Ladies and gentlemen, that will be it for the Springtime Most Media Free For All Tournament 3's Grand Finals Mappool Showcase. Ooh. Sir, you have quite the hill to climb.
I very much do. I have to beat the person who beat me in semifinals and then face Intel. Oh boy.
Well, best of luck to you. Congrats on getting this far as well.
It is quite unreal, I guess, is the word to use here. So with that, I guess that is going to be the final Mappool showcase that we are ever going to show for the third rendition of the Springtime Us Mania free-for-all tournament. We will have two or possibly three matches incoming for the next weekend. The first one being played will be the Losers Bracket Grand Finals, and that is going to be myself, the Toaster, versus Lothus. The winner of that match will then go on for the Grand Finals match to face Intelizer. If Intel wins that first match, it is over. He will take the title of champion. But if the one coming from the Losers Bracket wins that first match, it will be a rematch. Whoever wins that will then be crowned champion of Springtime Us Mania Free For All Tournament 3rd Edition.
Yep.
One weekend left.
One final weekend left. Hope everyone here stays tuned and ready for the matches next weekend.
Yeah, hopefully we'll get to see some very entertaining matches.
Yep. Any final words from you, Toaster?
Other than I really hope I don't embarrass myself next weekend. Not really.
Well, only time will tell, trademark. Oh, and we are joined by Juan Cree.
He told me I was going to get screwed, and I don't think he's completely wrong. We'll have to see when I, play the match next weekend, though.
Indeed. But, yeah, I guess, I don't know if Juan has anything else to say, because I'm also pretty much set for this. He's not getting off of mute.
No.
Oh, okay, there we go.
I don't have anything to say, don't worry. I'll have my things to say when the tournament is over, but for now, we still have one more week.
Yep.
He just wants to shove the difficulty of Grand Finals in my face and I'm playing it.
Yep.
No, totally not, man. I was talking to Lotus and Intel.
Hey, at least there's not a long crystal map. Ha! Shit roasted.
Fire.
You're actually challenging me to do that on SOFT4? Hey. Okay.
SOFT4 confirmed, guys.
See, the difference is I have a map in this pool and you don't.
Oh, I can change that right
do
now.
It. Do it right now. I want you to.
Yeah, no ball. Are you challenging me? Yeah, sure. Actually, that will help you, so no way.
It will help me. Absolutely.
All right. I think that's going to be it from us, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks, everyone, for watching. Tune in next week for the conclusion of the Springtime Osamania Free-For-All Tournament 3.